Police chases often end in crashes, and sometimes claim innocent bystanders, most recently Jose Madrid Salcido. About a month after that fatal crash, the Minneapolis Police Department quietly updated its pursuit policy.
Officers will still have to use their judgment, but what we've found is that it's necessary to be clear in the policy itself.
Mayor Jacob Frey supports the changes that Chief Medario Arredondo put in place. In essence, officers aren't supposed to start a chase unless they know the suspect has committed or is about to commit a violent felony such as murder, kidnapping, carjacking, or terrorism. They can still chase any suspect who's driving so erratically as to put others in danger.
These high-speed chases should really be a last resort and limited to violent crimes, limited to cases where you need an officer to necessarily go after the individual, and that's not the case with some of these lower-level offenses.
The Minneapolis PD was unable to make somebody available to talk to us about this today, but law enforcement experts we consulted say they believe this new pursuit policy is a step in the right direction.
We checked with retired Minneapolis police officer Mike Quinn.
If what they're doing would not be punishable by death, why would we put them into a pursuit where death is likely or highly likely?
And David P. Schultz, who spent 34 years training officers how to safely pursue suspects and spin them out using the pit maneuver, also likes what he hears coming from Minneapolis.
Unless it's a dramatic